Friday night. I'm in Three Rivers, just outside of Sequoia National Park. I was invited by a few friends to come and do the half of the Big Seki Loop over the next week. So tomorrow morning we start from Road's End and do the northern half of the Big Seki Loop. The Seki Loop, which means the Sequoia Kings Canyon Loop. Gonna head up north and then circle and end with half of the Rae Lakes Loop down Bubbs Creek to end back at Road's End in about a week. It's really warm. It was 100 degrees here when I got to the campsite. Luckily, we're gonna head up to higher ground tomorrow, so hopefully we'll have some cooler weather. 100 degrees is no fun to hike in. So we have started our trip and we've gone a few hundred yards, and this is Bubbs Creek up here where we will return on the last day. Here you can see the swings above Bubbs Creek. Cool feature. So it's around 2:30. We've climbed 2,500 feet in 5 miles. And we have 2,500 more feet to climb in 5 more miles. So it's pretty slow going. It's very warm today. It was 81 when we started at the parking lot. So pretty hard day. Well, just have to keep pushing on. Here we got Palmer Mountain and Avalanche Peak. And way out in the background, to the right there, you can see Mount Silliman. That's one of my favorites. Amazing views from Mount Silliman. It's the one to the right here. What a stunning view. The views are intense. We have reached the lip, and this has a survey marker here saying we're at 10,347 feet above sea level. Looking into the Grand Lake basin here. Pretty cool place. Up here is Granite Pass that we're gonna climb up tomorrow. For today, we're gonna camp down here in the Granite Basin. If we find water.
Okay, we found camp. Setting up on this flat rock here.
Day one, we hiked up from Road's End up towards Granite Basin, climbed about 5,500 feet up to the lip, and camped here in Granite Basin.
There's the Granite Meadows with a Granite Pass up to the right. Approaching Granite Pass, got about half a mile left to go, or less. Look at all these pretty flowers here. Just below the pass. Final approach now to Granite Pass. Should be right here in the notch. Granite Pass, wow. Yeah, this is why we do this. What a pretty little drainage here coming down from Granite Pass. just beauty everywhere here below Granite Pass. We have a thunderstorm, and over there is Granite Pass. We came over earlier this day. Looking into the Middle Fork Kings River, this is where we're gonna head down and make camp. Amazing views. And it is actually hailing on us right now. Crazy weather. Been so hot, and then get a hailstorm. Down in Simpson Meadows after 4,000 feet of descent. Pretty tired now. That was longer and harder than I thought it would be. My legs hurt.
Day two, we started at Granite Basin, headed over Granite Pass, followed the Simpson Meadow Trail, and climbed down here to Simpson Meadow. This was a 4,000 feet descent, pretty hard.
We have started day three, and it looks like we're gonna be in a lot of brush today, getting wet. So that's gonna be fun. Very pretty here. Simpson Meadows, or Simpson Meadow. We're in the Middle Fork of Kings River, and we're gonna head up to join with the JMT. Should be about 8.5 miles from where we camped by Simpson Meadow.
So situation report after half the way up Middle Fork of Kings River. This sucks. It's just a combination of too hot, a lot of bugs, and the trail has a lot of bushwhacking. So you get into a lot of these bushes where you just have to, it's not like bad bushwhacking, it's just annoying when you're hot and it's humid here and it's a lot of bugs. So don't want to do this again. Let's hope the last half is prettier and better. The river is pretty, but I don't know. Not my favorite part of the Sierras. Sorry.
So this is the Devil's Washbowl. It has started raining on us, just like yesterday. Got some thunderstorms rolling in.
Little Fork, Kings River. It got pretty cool. I hope it continues to be pretty cool as we get closer to the JMT. Look at this cave here. It's pretty cool. So we have reached the John Muir Trail. It's gonna be great. Here's our camp for night 3. Day 3, we started at Simpson Meadow and headed up the middle fork of Kings River, past Devil's Washbowl, and up to join the John Muir Trail at Palisade Creek. We camped around here. It's day number 4. We're heading up Palisade Creek towards the Golden Staircase and Palisade Lakes. It's a beautiful day. Sunny and bright and shiny.
soon we're gonna start climbing up in here. That's where the golden staircase is supposed to be. It's gonna be exciting. This is a look back at where we came up today. It's 10 a.m. now. We've been hiking for 2 hours. We camped way down there at the bottom. This is gorgeous. So we're done with the golden staircase. Pretty incredible climb. That was a lot of fun. The views are just extraordinary. We're approaching the Palisade Lake Basin. This is incredible. Can't wait to see those lakes.
Palisade Lakes. Pretty amazing.
Found a pretty cool spot here along Palisade Lakes. Looks like thunderstorms coming in. On day four, we started from here and had a beautiful day going up the JMT and climbing the Golden Staircase, camping between the two Palisade Lakes right here.
We have started day five with a climb up from our beautiful campsite. Gonna be heading up to Mather Pass in the notch up there. Just looking back at Palisade Lakes.
What if it was a bear? I have a runny nose. I'm finding it harder to breathe.
Getting close to Mather Pass, which is at around 12,000 feet. It's stunning out here. Beautiful morning. So cool. Up there's the pass. I'd say we have half a mile to go. So amazing. Here we are, Mather Pass. Stunning. Looking back on Palisade Lakes.
coming off Mather Pass now. That was a stunning pass. Really beautiful. Highly recommend it. Views were amazing to both the north and the south side. Here's the pass. And here's where we headed. Just spectacular scenery everywhere. So pretty.
No wonder John Muir called this the Range of Light.
Absolutely speechless from the scenery here. So amazing.
Hey there! Oh yeah, get that food. Beautiful animal.
There's Mather Pass way out in the distance. How cool is that?
Wow.
That's amazing.
Ooh. Is that dip where the pass was?
Yeah.
100% no. Now it's a good time.
Um,
Hello there. This is quite easily one of the most stunning places I've ever been. So we're getting close to Lake Marjorie, where we're gonna camp. Heading up this beautiful valley here. Incredible. This terrain we're going through now is just absolutely spectacular. Definitely one of the prettiest places I've ever been. So cool. So we have reached a camp overlooking Lake Marjorie. Pretty stunning. Pinchot Pass should be up to the left somewhere. Day 5, we headed up and over Mather Pass. Beautiful pass, one of my favorite passes in the Sierras. We headed down the upper basin, stunning place, all the way down to South Fork of Kings River, where we climbed up an amazing valley here up to Lake Marjorie, where we had camped. Got really cold that night at Lake Marjorie.
pretty cool camp here. Above Lake Marjorie. We're going to start the day by going over Pinchot Pass, which you can see up to the left here, or it's probably hidden behind that ridge there. But we have started day 6. We had a pretty cold night last night. We had some ice on some of the gear that was left outside of the tent, and I had to put my rain fly on just to stay warm. It's a beautiful morning now, though. Can't wait to see this pass. Up there is Pinchot Pass. Should be another 500 feet of elevation gain. And the pass is a little over 12,000 feet.
Wow. Pinchot Pass. Pinchot Pass, 12,130. A little bit higher than yesterday's pass.
Look at him.
This basin here at the foot of Pinchot Pass and at the head of Bubbs Creek is just amazing. Incredible mountains. Almost looks like Zion National Park up there. Just heading down Bubbs Creek here to get to camp. Planning to camp around a suspension bridge somewhere. Tomorrow we're going up here towards Rae Lakes. Time to cross the suspension bridge. Found a place to call camp just by the suspension bridge, and it's starting to rain. Day 6 started at Lake Marjorie, headed over Pinchot Pass, and walked down Bubbs Creek to the suspension bridge where we crossed and made camp right by the suspension bridge. It's day 7. Just gonna head up to Rae Lakes today. It's gonna be about 6 miles, shortest day of the trip. It's really beautiful going up from Bubbs Creek towards Rae Lakes. We have reached Dollar Lake, the first of the lakes in the Rae Lakes Basin. Pretty lake. So beautiful. Sauerkraut.
Up here is Mount Clarence King. Very prominent feature in the area. Approaching Arrowhead Lake now. Arrowhead Lake. Such an awesome spot. Also looking back up Bubbs Creek, way back there beyond that red slope. The Rae Lakes are a stunning sight. We've got Glen Pass up to the right there, where we're going tomorrow. Look at this stunning water here. Absolutely amazing. Got the colors of the water here. Filming straight down now from my campsite. Got in camp at noon. Got a good afternoon to spend here at the Rae Lakes. Here's my camp. Got my tent set up in a pretty cool spot here.
Some of my friends taking a swim.
Oh, what?
We got some really dark clouds rolling in.
soaking in the rain. Painted lady being lit up.
Day 7, the shortest day of our trip. We just started at the suspension bridge by Bubbs Creek and headed up to Rae Lakes, where we camped between the two upper Rae Lakes. Beautiful camp.
It's day 8, looking out of the tent at Rae Lakes. Sun is not up yet.
The sun is out and it's a beautiful morning.
Heading up to Glen Pass, which you can see up there to the left. It's one of my favorite passes. Amazing views from up there. Walking straight towards Mount Rixford in front of me there, and Painted Lady to the left. Not far to go now. Pass is right up there. Rae Lakes way out there. Thank you. Alright, so here we are, Glen Pass, one of my favorite passes. Looking down on the other side of the divide. Glen Pass. Heading down off Glen Pass. It's a pretty cool trail down here. Glen Pass up there. Look at the color of this water. Amazing.
We're off Glen Pass, and now it's all downhill from here, down to Rhodes End tomorrow. Down here is Charlotte Lake. And over here is Charlotte Dome, that little arrow point out there. So amazing out here. Just beautiful. Wish we could continue on the JMT, but we have to quit tomorrow. So this is it. We're done with the JMT section of our hike and we're gonna head down towards Rhodes End. Awesomeness. So pretty. Bubbs Creek. Junction Meadow, 12 miles to Rhodes End here. Keeps getting longer with every sign. So exactly where I found the bear last time. Here's a big rattlesnake. Stay out of its way. The largest rattlesnake I've seen.
This is the same bird. Why aren't you paying more attention to me?
Girl, that was really cool being in Amsterdam and hearing like teenagers speaking Dutch and all of a sudden they say.
Day 8. We started from Rae Lakes, went over Glen Pass, down to Vidette Meadows, and camped down Bubbs Creek, where Bubbs Creek meets Charlotte Creek. It's 5 a.m., day 9. Ready to get up early and be out of here. It's our last day. It's been a fantastic 9 days doing the northern half of the Big Seki Loop. Had a great time. Seen a lot of magnificent nature. Beautiful views. Stunning out here. So just gonna head on down to Rhodes End now. I think it's between 6 and 8 miles down. And we have an early start. It's 6 a.m. now. Can't wait to see this place again. But for now, I'm glad to get down and get some food and maybe get clean. That'd be nice.
very thankful that I got invited on this trip. A lot of fun. Great people to hang out with.
Nearly at road's end. 2 miles to go now.
Day 9, the last day, we just headed down Bubbs Creek and all the way back to the car at road's end. Approximately 8 miles for that last day there.